Verse 5, thou feedest them with the bread of tears, and givest them tears to drink in good measure. Now that is one of the most remarkable verses that you have in the Word of God. He says that he gave to these people tears to drink, tears for their bread. That's all they had to eat were tears. And these are tears of suffering. No nation has suffered as these people have and survived. Most other nations that have been treated as they've been treated on several occasions would have been exterminated and disappeared from the face of the earth. Now, this nation here has been drinking tears down through the centuries. Why? Well, give ear, O shepherd of Israel, because the shepherd of Israel has heard them. Not only has he heard them, he has been rejected. And we read in Luke 19, and when he was come near, he beheld the city, and he wept over it. The Lord Jesus, you'll recall, came to Jerusalem the last time. Now, he didn't weep for himself at that time. Remember when the daughters of Jerusalem were weeping, he said, weep not for me. You weep for yourself. You are the one that you should weep for, because he said, don't weep for me. Now, will you notice, I'll read now Luke 19, beginning with verse 42, saying, if thou hadst known, even thou, at least in this thy day, the things which belong unto thy peace, but now they're hid from thine eyes, for the days shall come upon thee, that thine enemies shall cast a trench about thee, compass thee around, keep thee in on every side, and shall lay thee even with the ground, thy children with thee. They shall not leave thee one stone upon another, because thou knewest not the time of thy visitation. That is a tremendous passage of Scripture, and that's the reason they've had that to drink. Now again, here is this cry, verse 7 of Psalm 80, restore us, O God of hosts, cause thy face to shine, and we shall be saved. Now again, what is the face to shine? Well, that face to shine is none other than the Messiah, the Lord Jesus Christ. Now he says here, and this is another remarkable verse, verse 8, thou hast brought a vine out of Egypt. Thou hast cast out the nations and planted it. God brought them and put them in the land. Now, their temple is to be destroyed. They're going out of the land. Why? For the same reason these nations were put out. Why? Because they turned their back upon God, and the responsibility of Israel was greater because they had privileges that no other nation had had. They had the visible presence of God. Now, he says here, thou preparest room before it. Thou didst cause it to take deep root and fill the land. That's the vine. God says, I'm putting it out of the land. The hills were covered with the shadow of it. The boughs thereof were like the goodly cedars. And now the question arises, why hast thou then broken down the hedges, so that all they who pass by the way do pluck her? God for years put a hedge around that land. And it's quite interesting. Those people were in that land for, I suppose, a good 500 years. And they were never touched. God never permitted any of the great nations of that day to destroy them. Egypt came against them, got victories, but never destroyed them. The same was true of Assyria, the Hittite nations. But there came a day when God put down the hedge and let them come in. Why? They'd rejected the shepherd of Israel. What a beautiful picture this is of him. Now he says here in verse 17, let thy hand be upon the man of thy right hand. And that's the place of power. And who's at God's right hand? It is their Messiah. Sit thou on my right hand till I make thy enemies thy footstool. That's a remarkable picture that we have here. You remember that when Rachel was dying along the roadside that leads into Bethlehem, she wasn't even able to make it to a stable back of an inn. And you remember Benjamin was born, but she didn't call him that. when she looked upon that little fella that she'd just given birth to and she's dying, she says, call him Benoni's, the son of my suffering. And old Jacob looked at him, and I think he had the eyes of his lovely Rachel, and he said, we're going to call him Benjamin. He's the what? The son of my right hand. That's the Lord Jesus. He's the son of suffering. He came the first time. But he's today on God's right hand. Sit thou on my right hand till I make thy enemies thy footstool. And he's coming someday from there to this earth. Now will you notice? Verse 18, so will not we go back from thee, revive us. We'll call upon thy name. And then here's the chorus for the third time. Restore us, O Lord God of hosts, cause thy face to shine upon us. This is a wonderful, wonderful